the value of one currency in terms of the other. So when I say rupees 61 per USD, so rupees 61 per dollar, wherein my base currency is typically the kind of foreign currency we look at. We generally call it, we generally take the base currency. Let's say I'm an Indian, I'm operating from India, and I'm expressing the value of one USD in terms of Indian rupees. So in this case, when I represent an exchange rate something like this, 61 rupees per USD, it means one US dollar is going to cost me 61 rupees. And another term wise, USD is called as a base currency for me, whereas Indian currency is called as the price currency, just as a comfort level with respect to the terminology. And when it comes to the exchange rate market, we have a spot market versus a forward market. So even the exchange rates wise, we see a spot exchange rate versus a forward exchange rate. So whenever I'm thinking of buying or selling currencies, immediately buy or sell currencies immediately in the current at the current market price, I call it as a spot transaction. Generally the currencies the currency possessing happens within 2 days of placing the trade in case of spot market. Whereas when we talk about a forward market, the buying or selling of the currencies happen sometime at a future date. Generally, let's say we have something like a 30-day forward rate or a 60-day forward rate or a 90-day forward rate, something like that, wherein the real buying and selling do not happen today, but they happen at a future date, whereas the price setting, whereas the price at which the currency would be bought or sold would be decided today itself. That is a typical forward market, just like any other derivative based market. Now this kind of exchange currency based market, generally the transactions happen through the dealers. We have foreign exchange currency dealers, and the buying and selling happen through these dealers. The dealers typically have two quotes with them, or two rates with them. One is called as a bid rate, and the other one is called as an ask rate. And the ask rate is also otherwise called as an offer rate. So bid rate is always the rate at which the dealer buys the currency from the customer. So probably if let's say for the same USD, the dealer will have a kind of a bid rate saying 59 and an ask rate, let's say, saying 62 rupees per dollar. It means the dealer is willing to pay 59 rupees to purchase a dollar, whereas if he has to sell the dollar to you, he will be charging you 62 rupees. So basically this difference is what we call as the bid ask spread. 3 rupees in this case is the typical bid ask spread, because this is the prices. Whenever we talk about the bid and the ask prices, they are primarily from the perspective of the dealer, not from the perspective of the individual customers. So bid is the buy price for the dealer, and ask is the sell price for the dealer. And the gap between bid and ask is the spread. And the spread again depends on various factors. The way generally the spread is quoted is in terms of 1/10,000. So 1/10,000 is actually called as a pip. So the generally the spread is quoted in the form of pip. So basically in this case probably I could have shown it as 3 rupees. So otherwise it would be shown in terms of 30,000, because 1/10,000 is typically the pip. So when I say the buy price versus the sell price, so in terms of pip, the same 3 rupees would be expressed in the form of 30,000, right? Because whenever the difference is, let's say, 0.05 rupees. So if the bid is 59.52 and ask is 59.57, then probably the difference is 0.05, and the 0.05 is expressed in the form of 10,000. So you multiply this by 10,000, so which will give you 500 pips. So that's a typical way the currency spreads are typically being talked about, and the various things that influence the spread. When I look at factors that are influencing the spread, so primarily it can be classified into the size of the transaction. The higher, the larger the size, generally if the buy sell is in very large volumes, the liquidity will become an issue. The liquidity will be much lesser, which in turn will result in spread being higher. So the size of the transaction is one of the important determinants in the spread. Sometimes the relationship that for some clients, a favorable rates will be given by the dealers. So client-dealer relationship could also be a factor that could influence the spread. But see, the major thing that creates a difference is what is the spread that is prevailing in the interbank market. Because most of the times, the dealers maintain their foreign currency inventory by doing the trading in the interbank market. So they generally get into the buy sell transactions, especially by doing appropriate trades in the interbank market. So the spread in the interbank market will determine the spread for the dealers. So the spread, if it is lesser in the interbank market, when can it be lesser? Especially if the currencies are if the currencies are more and more liquid, right? So high volume kind of trading happening on some currency pairs, there the spreads will be lesser. But for those pairs where the volumes are less, there the spread will be higher, because it's again associated with the liquidity itself. But much more than that, what is understood is, especially when both the currency markets, the New York currency market as well as London currency market, both these currency markets, when both of them are open, the time frame during which both of them are open, it is expected that the liquidity is very high during that period, which will again result in the spreads going lower during that particular period. And also the volatility of the existing markets, exchange rate fluctuations, the volatility of exchange rate, if the exchange rate is fluctuating drastically for that particular exchange rate, we see that the spread will be higher. But whichever exchange rate is more and more stable, probably the spreads of the dealers also will be stable in this regard. So before we get into the calculations aspect, understanding the basic transaction of the forex market is really required. And typically when we are talking about forward markets, the spreads are more higher and higher based on the maturity. If the maturity period is very long, we see that the spread will be much higher because liquidity will be an issue. Similarly, counterparty credit risk will be much higher in case of long-term contracts. So the counterparty credit risk also, because it is higher, obviously long-term forward contracts will have a bigger problem. And similarly, the interest rate risk also will be a bigger problem because the interest rates can fluctuate quite drastically during this period. So because of all these reasons, what we see is the forward rates in a long-term maturity contracts are much more higher compared to the forward rates for a short-term maturity contract. So the basic structure of the currency markets is something which we need to understand before getting into the calculations involving the foreign exchange currency, including the foreign currency. All right. So when there is a typical quote which is saying rupees 59.23 to rupees 59.75. So what it means, from a dealer's perspective, the dealer would be buying a dollar. This is, let's say, the rupee to dollar kind of a exchange rate. So the dealer will buy at 59.23, which means if I look at it from an investor standpoint, investor has to sell $1 to the dealer at 59.23, and investor can buy $1 at 59.75. So basically, if the investor is interested in buying the base currency, right, if the investor is interested in buying the base currency is always like, for one unit of base currency, what is the price currency? That currency is what we call as a base currency. So if the investor is interested in the base currency, the buying, he should always buy at the ask rate, whereas the selling, he will be doing at the bid rate. And the same logic, let's say if he is going for a price currency. So look at it like this. He wants to buy rupee. If I want to buy rupee, right, the investor has, let's say from an investor standpoint, he wants to buy rupee. So if he is wanting to buy rupee, he has to sell dollar. Selling the dollar happens at the bid rate. Selling the base currency happens at the bid rate. So buying the price currency happens at the bid rate, and selling the price currency happens at the ask rate. So this relationship also we need to be comfortable with, depending on whether the person is, depending on the quote that is available, am I buying the base currency or the price currency? If I am buying the base currency, it should be at the ask rate. But if I am buying the price currency, it should be a bid rate. And entirely opposite exists if I am selling the base currency or selling the price currency. So whenever any kind of situation comes, let's say I have an exchange rate. Now, if I want to look at a quick numerical in this case, let's say I have an exchange rate saying rupees